Last week, I talked about how to become a millionaire. And in a nutshell, you have to figure out a way to generate cash flow, whether it's through a business or employment. And then you take that cash flow and you invest it in properties or investments like stocks or bonds. What I wanted to talk to you about today was an asset class that I favor and a lot of investors favor, and that's real estate. And we're just going to touch on it at a high level because there's not enough time to go through everything in a short video. So, what are real estate investments? What are the options available to you? There's a lot of options, one being land itself. So you could buy land and hold it, or you can buy land and develop it. You could also buy properties for the purposes of renting them out, single family homes, condos, multifamily dwellings, commercial property. You could also buy properties yourself that you buy them, you renovate them in a year or two or even shorter periods, like 6 months, and then you sell them and you hopefully get profit from improving the value of the property. Or you can buy properties that somebody else, like a developer, has bought the land and they have a dream for a vision, a community, and you'll invest in that dream. So you're buying what's called pre-construction properties. You're getting in early, 3 or 5 years before the property is done, but you're locking in the value today. Usually you're buying at the current purchase price, and hopefully values go up as time go on. So by the time the property finishes in 5 years and you get the keys, the property's already increased in value to the kind of current market rate. So how do you decide, well, what am I going to invest in? Where do I start? What's a better avenue for me to go down? So here's a few different perspectives that I would have. One, you should have, in an ideal scenario, you should have a variety of investments to have a variety of time horizons. I wouldn't necessarily focus on all your money or resources on one single thing. And the way I look at it is I treat it like a garden. You have some plants or some plants or flowers that are going to grow very quickly. You have some that take years, but when they're done, they're very, very beautiful and they're worth the time that you waited for them to grow. It's the same thing like real estate. If you place it on a scale, land, if you buy for speculation, is definitely the longest term, usually the longest term horizon before you see a return. But the return is probably the greatest of all compared to all the assets. And I don't mean a piece of land that's already in an existing city that's booming. I mean a piece of land that's maybe 50 kilometers or 50 miles outside of a major city. And 20 years from now, that area is now hot, transit's being built there, and people are looking to buy up land so they can develop it, or you can develop it yourself. If you're just starting out, I would definitely say that probably the two avenues you'd look at is either buying a rental property, and that's probably the lowest maintenance and easiest avenue for you to get financing from a bank. The next easiest option, aside from that, and assuming you don't buy pre-construction, because that's kind of in the land of rental property, because you can rent that property out after, would be property renovations. But renovations are actually a lot of work, and you really have to know what you're doing. Otherwise, you might not be able to make a profit or make very little profit. And you also have to have more cash flow available. So, with that in mind, number one, you should figure out how much money you realistically have to make your investment. And once you know that, then you should figure out where's the best use of those funds. So if you have $100,000 and you want to make your first property investment as a rental property and you live in New York City, New York City is great and it's always booming and there's always going to be a demand to live in New York. But is the growth going to be the same there as maybe another city that's up and coming? Or will that $100,000 investment actually get you a property that has a lot of potential? So in New York, that might get you a small one bedroom, condo in Manhattan. But in a smaller city that's up and coming, that has a lot of potential, that could buy you an apartment building, maybe a 5 or 7 unit apartment. Or it could buy you a house that has 3 units in it. And that city might be experiencing 10 or 15% growth every year because it's up and coming. And maybe it's just on the outskirts of a bigger city. So you really need to figure out how much money you have and then look at what's the best avenue to invest that money where you're going to get the best return. And doing the best thing with your money is not necessarily the most comfortable thing. So it might be more comfortable to invest in a city that you know, but it might make more sense to spend time doing the research because that's going to overall yield you a much better result. Once you make your first investment, in a property, you need to be patient and know that you might have to wait a little while before you make your next investment. A, the banks are going to want to see that that property's been rented out. It's going to be generating cash flow. And then B, you know, you're going to have to accumulate sufficient cash to be able to buy the next property. The good news is the more properties you get, it gets easier and easier to borrow, probably up until the point that you get between 6 and 10 properties. Once you go over that, then there is a period of time where it gets more challenging, and then again, it will get easier again. You will learn as time goes on that there's a lot of tricks and tips that you can follow to kind of help the process. So one thing I found is you need to look at different lenders and different banks, and eventually you'll be able to find someone who is more willing to lend to you. And then once you find that person, you exhaust that relationship. So you keep borrowing from them until they say no. And then you find the next lender. And then eventually you'll kind of continue to go through that process. But going back at a high level, really look at what your time horizon is for investments and what you're expecting out of it. And then figure out realistically how much you can invest comfortably and figure out the best way for you to invest that money where you're going to get the best return. Even if that involves you doing some homework, traveling, research, you know, hundreds of viewings, inconveniencing yourself and going to another city, it's worth it because in the long run, it's going to actually shave off years of you reaching the retirement goal.